The Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
Dear Lord, thank you for this time together, and thank you for allowing us to come together and do what's right in your eyes. God, just bless us as we're here together, and bless us as Alamance County, and please look on us as you would have us do what is in your will. And we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Move to stand. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The first item of business is to approve the agenda. Do we have a motion to approve the agenda?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Ladies and gentlemen, the only item of other business on the agenda tonight is the public hearing for the budget ordinance fiscal year 2014-15. Public hearing. In the public hearing, each speaker will be allowed 3 minutes to speak. If you'd come up to the mic here and give your name, you can speak. You will hear a little bell, I think, when your 3 minutes is up. And do we have a motion to go into public hearing?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
We are now in the public hearing. Ladies and gentlemen, those who would like to be heard, if you would please come on down and come to the microphone. Do we have any over on this side? Any in the back? I'm sorry, I can't see nor hear a thing up here, but I hope you can hear me. Anybody in the center? Anybody in the... Got one? Yes, sir. Come right on up. Hey.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. My name is Henry Vines from Snow Camp. I just wanted to come tonight and express my concerns over the proposed budget. I think we're headed down the road that we headed down 5 years ago when we are setting a budget that is projecting an income revenues of $2.5 million that are in the increase using $2.5 million of our fund balance. I don't think that we should use our fund balance to balance our budget. I've said this before, and I think we're headed in the same direction that we done 5 years ago. I think we shouldn't repeat history. Also, I'm concerned about the part of $4.5 million increase in our budget, which does not even allow for an increase in salary for our county employees. I feel like that's unfair to them. I do appreciate that that the tenure is going, you know, the not the tenure, but the salaries for the teachers are going to go up, the supplement. But I think that is not fair to the county employees to not even be considered in a raise. So these are my concerns, and I hope that y'all will take these into advisement and not pass a budget that is created on, I hate to say this, but on smoke and screen, where you got $2.5 million of projected increase in income, and then using $2.5 million out of our fund balance again. I don't want to see our fund balance get down like it did before, and we get another letter from the state. And I'd appreciate your concerns on that.
Thank you, Henry. Anyone else? Please come forward.
Good evening. My name is Dana Roseborough, and I'm a teacher here in Alamance County. I've been a public educator for 24 years, 19 of which are here. And my statement is just short and sweet. I just would request that you all please fully fund the Alamance-Burlington school system. We haven't been fully funded in several years. It's not about a salary increase for me at this point. What I really care about are the kids. We have overcrowded schools. We have teachers having classrooms in what were formerly the equipment rooms, dismantling computer labs, in order to make classrooms. We have no, you know, we're talking about losing assistant principals in schools that desperately need them. And I'm just asking you to fully fund us for the kids. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else?
Good evening. My name is Ariel Hogarth, and I'm in my ninth year teaching at Eastern Alamance High School. I'm just coming to ask you to please consider Dr. Cox's recommendation for the budget for Alamance Burlington School Systems. In light of some of the tough situations that are coming down from Raleigh, we fully need y'all's support with what's going on in our school system. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? Seeing no one else who wants to be heard, do I have a motion to go out of public hearing?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
The floor is now open for discussion of the budget. Commissioners, for the commissioners. Anyone have anything to say? Do I hear a motion?
I'd like to make a comment or two if you don't mind. Last year, I've got a piece of candy due to my cough, I apologize. Our board voted 3-2 to raise taxes from 52 to 54. And it's my belief that that was done not knowing what the final figures were going to be for fiscal 2013-14, if that's the right fiscal year. And then after that was done, the dollars were finalized, and we had the almost to the tune of $3.5 million come in. We were barely thinking we were going to hit 8% as a fund balance. And it's my understanding that after everything settled, all the dust cleared, that we were over 15, pushing 16. What was that percentage?
16.57.
Yeah, 16 and a half. In other words, it practically doubled. And it was my understanding at that time that it was said that if it had been known that the fund balance would have come down at that rate versus what we thought, the 8%, but it went to what again, 16?
0.57.
Whatever, almost double, that the 2 cent tax increase would have never been approved, possibly even by the three that did vote for it. Or the motion might not have been made for the two, which I opposed. And Bill did too, the vote was 3-2. It's my belief, I asked our finance person to give us a chart of what the fund balance would be if we left the tax rate at 54 versus if we cut it to 53 with this upcoming budget. In other words, approve the budget that's on the table. There's things in the budget I don't like. I think there's things in there we, all of us, you know, there's certain things we all don't like, but they're different. So we can't have it perfect. So I'm not going to nitpick the budget at all. But I would say that I believe that we can have a sufficient fund balance at 18.25.
18.33.
Yeah, even higher, 8.33, if we cut taxes from 54 to 53. Because it's my understanding that if we left it at 54 and approved this budget, that it would be at what, 19.25. So my motion, I would like to make a motion under the belief that the fund balance would be sufficient. It would be at an adequate percentile, that if we cut it from 54 to 53, we could approve the budget as submitted, cut taxes a penny, and still have a sufficient fund balance at the end of the fiscal year 2014-15. And my motion is just that.
Your motion is to cut the tax rate from 54 to 53 for the next fiscal year.
Yes, sir.
I'll second that.
A Any other discussion on this motion? Hearing none, all in favor of the motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
No.
No. The motion carries 3-2.
Who was the second? I heard one. I heard one.
Me. I voted no.
Opposed it.
Yeah. John and I opposed it, Tim.
You voted for it the first time.
Yeah. 3-2, the motion carries. Is there any other motions concerning the budget?
I'll make a motion. We passed the with that 1 cent decrease. Pass the budget with a 1 cent decrease in taxes.
All right. The Mr. Vice Chairman, your motion is that the budget be passed, but that the rate be set at 53 cents. We'll leave it up to staff to cut.
That's correct.
Cut the projected budget down. Is that correct?
Yes.
Is there a second?
I'm sorry. I couldn't hear what the motion is.
The motion is that the budget pass the budget, but that the tax rate will be cut from 54 to 53, and that the staff, the manager, will decide where to cut that 1 cent out of the his projected budget.
Well, now you can carry the budget at 53, approve the budget as is. You just won't have the same replenishment back in the fund.
Okay,
is that not correct?
That's true.
Yes.
So.
Okay. Well, anyway, that's going to be the same thing.
Sorry, what is the motion?
The manager's going to make that decision.
Well, he's suggesting cuts in the budget.
You've already passed a cut in the budget. I mean,
the rate. I'm talking about cutting the rate and leaving the budget as is.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
And take the difference from fund balance.
But you would just have less put in the fund balance.
Right.
See, we're going from 19 what?
Well, it would be an additional appropriation of the fund balance for the next year in the amount of approximately $1.2 million, which is a penny on the tax rate.
Right.
So if that happens and our projections are accurate, the resulting available fund balance percentage at the year end 2015 would be 18.33% instead of 19.25%.
Right.
Everything else would remain the same.
Okay.
Does everybody understand the motion?
Yep.
We're passing the budget with a 53-cent tax rate.
Right.
And, Mr. Chairman, that would include the modifications that we made in the last meeting, the reclassification, for example?
Yes. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct.
Is there a second to the motion?
I thought we'd already done it. I apologize. What am I missing?
We need a second to Bill's motion. We had to get it straight first.
Was that not what we did on the first motion?
Well,
okay.
The motion was changed.
I'll second it.
All right, go ahead.
Any further discussion from the board concerning the motion? Hearing none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Budget passes 5-0. Any other commissioners' comments this evening? Hearing none, do we have a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.